Good morning. We are in St. John's, Antigua. This morning we're up in the veranda for breakfast. We are docked, so Janetta doesn't have to worry about the swing. We're going to eat some breakfast, chill out in the room for a while, and then just take a cab over to a place called Moose Jaw Junction. Do some shopping, hanging out. Basically just chilling today. We've been staying up rather late every night, 11, midnight, and if anybody knows this, they know that's way past our bedtime. We're gonna take it easy today and have a nice day on St. John's. Our hostess slash waitress this morning is Anne, and she was also our waitress down in Compass Rose. She remembered how I liked my milk, a glass of skim milk, and a glass of ice on the side. We are both having omelets this morning. I've also got some salmon and cream cheese and bacon and sausage. Janetta is doing muesli, omelet, and hash browns, which I meant to get but forgot. And it looks like a croissant and a croissant.
Oh my God. Juice and cappuccino.
Oh yeah, an orange juice and a cappuccino for Janetta. Because the light's better.
Where's your stand for that? Hmm? Where's your stand?
What's the rule? Why don't you mind your business? Eat your food.
I'm done. You don't have to do crazy stuff.
The ship docked right in town, and we walked over to the History Museum. The museum cost $3 per person to get in. It is small, but it does have some interesting exhibits regarding the slave trade and the emancipation of slaves on the island. Cricket is very important on the island, and there is an exhibit dedicated to Dr. Vivian Richards, one of their cricket heroes. It says that he broke the world's record for the fastest century ever made in a test match. I have no idea what that means. We took a taxi tour around the island. One of the most interesting places we stopped at was the cricket stadium. It's dedicated to Dr. Vivian Richards. Right now, we are visiting Nelson's Dockyard, which is a National Historic Site in Antigua. At Nelson Dockyards, unless you actually own one of the yachts and you're hanging out here as part of your yachting adventure, there's really not much here. Definitely not worth the $15 per person admission. Save your money, go somewhere else. Well, remember when I said we were gonna go to Moosehead Junction today? Well, turns out there are two St. John's. One is St. John's, its own island. And where we are, St. John's, Antigua. And Moosehead Junction is on St. John's, the island. So we ended up just getting in a cab and having them take us on a tour and going out to the Nelson's Dockyard. Weren't too happy with Nelson's Dockyard, but it was something to do.
You should say something. The tour guide was nice.
The taxi driver was real nice. It's from Paulson Taxi Services. Paulson Taxi Services, and his name was Paulson Farquhar.
You screwed that up.
No, that's what it is. Farquhar.
Farquhar, like that.
Or Fuqua, one of the two. Probably anyway, he was real nice. I forgot my money clip, so I had only enough cash to pay him his fee. Janetta had $20, and then I had another like $15. But the problem is, to get into Nelson's Dockyard, we needed $30. So he loaned us the money with the assurance that once we got back, I would go back to the ship and get the money I owed him. So I said, okay, well, if I don't make it back, you can keep Janetta. He didn't bite. But he was nice. I got back to the ship, gave him his money. No big deal.
Hello.
Hey, in our culture, that means you just married her, so she's yours now. Oh, thank you. Thank you. How you doing?
Doing amazing. Is that the 7?
This is a 7S3, yeah.
Nice, beautiful camera.
Thank you. At Sette Mari, they bring a first course of antipasti to your table. There is also a salad bar and more antipasti up at the buffet station. You order your first course and your entree from the menu, and to finish, there's a buffet section for desserts. So they brought some antipasti, mozzarella, bread, zucchini flowers, and bruschetta. Janetta, how do you say that?
Bruschetta.
Look at all this. I'm not even sure what most of these things are. But I will be tasting a lot of different things here. There's the prosciutto and melon. Mm-hmm. Mixings over here. Mini spinach, mushroom, and sun-dried tomatoes frittata, meatballs, Italian country tart.
Oh, calamari? What is that?
Is that calamari? It doesn't have a label.
No.
I'm guessing it's calamari.
Sure.
All right, so we both got an assortment here. I've got a shrimp, another bruschetta, some calamari. They didn't have separate tomato sauce, so I just poured some of the meatball sauce on top of it. Mm. Frittata, meatballs.
You need to eat yours from here.
I know, there's so much already. Janetta got just a small plate. She didn't get much at all.
I'm going to say room.
Room?
We got two.
There's plenty of room.
And we probably want to get dessert.
Yes.
I always like to get a tiramisu.
That was good. I left a little bit of my plate because I still have 2 courses coming.
Well, maybe 3 courses.
Yeah, maybe 3 courses because we have to remember there's dessert.
Yeah.
Tiramisu. Does it seem like they cut down on the number of things available at the bar?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I remember that there was a lot more selection. Yeah. But still good. It's more than enough to eat.
Yeah, I think that, it used to be like the spread at breakfast. It would go all the way around.
Yeah, I agree.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And then their little dessert here was more than just that little section. I mean, people get the vegetable one.
Good?
Yeah, that's good.
Of course more people get the vegetable one.
Huh?
Of course more people get the vegetable one. The pumpkin one is... Yep. And my lasagna here, and it's just the right size for a starter.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, thank you.
Mm. That's very good. Yep. Yep.
That the spoon fits perfectly around the curvature of the bowl.
Yeah, that's really important.
It is important. So
my lamb chops.
Right.
And Janetta had a veal chop. Which I'm surprised. I didn't think you ate veal.
What?
I thought you didn't like to eat veal. Got over that?
I don't know. I couldn't remember.
So we're both going to withdraw prematurely because we want to save room for tiramisu. I didn't do too bad, but Janetta
did
a poor job with her food.
I did an awful job.
Yep. Don't you know there are poor kids in India who would love to have that food? So they have ice cream. With all different kinds of toppings, a chocolate and raspberry marquee, fresh fruit minestrone, almond paste cookies and chocolate biscotti, tiramisu, rum cake, chocolate pistachio mousse, hazelnut tort, and extra virgin olive oil cake. So Janetta has tiramisu, cappuccino, and some sugar-free coffee fudge ice cream. That sounds horrible. I have the rum cake, the tiramisu, and a scoop of vanilla ice cream. That's very good. Yep. Tiramisu is good.
Yeah, it is good.
You try the rum cake? Also good.
Really?
Mm-hmm. And I know what vanilla ice cream tastes like, so I'm gonna put the camera down for that.
So this is sugar-free chocolate fudge.
Sugar-free chocolate fudge.
Let me see if it really tastes good.
Good?
Yeah.
Okay.
Never even know that it was sugar free. Oh, that was good. That was good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, good evening. Thank you.
Young people. Sette Mari is not a reservation-only restaurant on Regent, but it was very, very good. After my meal at Prime 7, I was feeling a little bit down on Regent, but Sette Mari restored my faith. Very good food, very good service, and especially very good desserts. Well, it's time to call it a night. That ends day 6 of our cruise. Tomorrow, we'll be arriving in St. Bart's. We'll see you then. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe.